One of the questions, another question is, how do you convert a manually controlled shot into one that you would save? Okay, and the short answer is there is no automatic way to do that. Because when you do this control with this here, you are controlling the flow and pressure with your finger, and there is tons of noisy data, right? The flow and the pressure is changing with every little micro change. And the espresso machine, first of all, is limited to 20 steps. So every little micro change would just fill up the 20 steps. Secondly, most of those micro changes are meaningless. They're not actually helpful for your coffee. Like at the start of mine, I went high, I went low, and stuff that doesn't make sense. So what you're really asking when you say, how do you convert a manually controlled espresso into an automatic one, is how would I author it? How would I go ahead making it? And let me show you how I would do it. What I would do is I would make the shot, and then I would save it as a God shot, because saving it as a God shot will save all the curves about it. So let's go ahead and do that. Hey, pitcher rinser works. Springing back nicely, and it's not going chug chug anymore. I am going to go into a manual flow mode. So settings, preset, manual flow control for the group head controller. Okay, now I'm going to hit start and nothing's happening. Okay, so I'm going to do a default profile. So I'm going to do 4 milliliters per second for about 10 seconds. And now the puck would be compressing, and I would be slowing down to something like 1.5 mils per second. Okay, until I hit my desired weight. And let's say the puck is speeding up, so I'm gonna just slow down. And then I hit stop. Okay, so I didn't have coffee in there, so there's not gonna be any pressure. Nonetheless, here's our blue line. Let me tap to zoom it. Okay, so we did a 4 milliliters per second pre-infusion, followed by 2 mils per second, followed by 1 mil per second, followed by a stop. Okay, so at this point, what I'm going to do is hit this heart icon that's here. Okay, and then I'm going to, in fact, I'll save it. Manual flow control with GHC. Let's just save it with that name. Okay, so now I hit here to make the keyboard go down. Okay, and if I go to settings and I hit OK. Now I have cleared the previous coffee, okay? But if I hit here, you can see there's the previous coffee there, okay? That's what I just did as my profile. Now, a couple things. One is, let's see if this works. Yeah. Cool, it's working, okay? So here we are, okay? And now, just like the Smart Espresso Profiler, I can go and do, okay. And I am trying to follow the line that's here. Okay, so this is the most natural way to do advanced shots, is to just follow the existing shot that you made. And then down to one. And then stop. Okay, so there you are, and I tap to zoom. So you can see the faint blue line was the shot that I made manually that I really liked. And the dark blue line is my attempt to imitate it fairly successfully. Okay, so that's the first thing, is if you want to just imitate manual shots and do it over and over again. This is very much what the Smart Espresso Profiler software does, only it's more optimized for this workflow. Okay, now if I want to create this shot an automated way. First of all, this is why I don't want to automatically convert the shot with software, is the first 8 seconds are garbage, right? There's nothing going on that I actually want there. I didn't start. So 4 mils followed by 2, followed by 1. Okay, the easiest thing, this is a 3-stage espresso, so this is really not complicated. This is a flow controlled shot, so I'm gonna hit plus flow, okay? And my pre-infusion here is going to be at 4 mils per second, okay? I'm gonna turn off the automatic exit, and it was 10 seconds. Okay, so there's my first step. And then I went to 2 mL/s for 20 seconds, like so. I think it was actually like 15 seconds. All right. And then I declined down to 1 mL/s for not that long. All right. So now I've made my profile. Let's see how close it is to the real thing. So I hit OK, and I hit go. Oops. By the way, that's what happens if you use a tablet on version 1.3. It tells you you have to put the group head. Okay. Now let's see how close mine is. Now it's offset because I don't have the 10 seconds at the beginning where nothing happens. And then I drop. Oh, it looks like the flow rate was a little lower. It was 1.5 mL/s at that last stage. And now we're gonna drop. Okay, and it looks like I also made this section a little too long and not slowing down enough. So there's the two mistakes. This is actually, the last stage is 0.5 mL/s and this is 1.5. So I go back here, there. All right, and this was a little shorter. All right, attempt number two. So there's a few things that are different. The notable ones are, A, my pre-infusion was longer, but this last one, see how this went slowly down as opposed to suddenly down? And that's because this shot, this profile is set by default to smoothly go from one flow to another, not quickly. Now, I can't make that change in that little wizard, but I'll show you how to do it using an advanced shot. So first thing I'll do though is make that pre-infusion just a little shorter. So we match that. And now I'm gonna go to plus and hit advanced. Now what's happened is I've just copied that shot that I made easily using the wizard, and now I can do an advanced shot. And the reason I'll do advanced is the last step is set to smooth. But actually when I did it manually, it was not. So I've tapped it and now it's gone to fast. Okay. Now we should be pretty close to my manual shot. Okay, you can see my pre-infusion time is closer. Now I've made it too short. And see, nice fast drop. See how that happened there? And now it really looks like my manual shot. So I've now made my own profile that really mimics what I did manually. And if that tasted great, great. Thank you.